Definitions and terminology, level one. The words differential and equation certainly suggest solving some kind of equation that contains derivatives. One of the main goals of a general differential equation course is to solve equations such as this one. For an unknown function y equals f of x, differential equations play a prominent role in engineering, physics, economics, chemistry, biology, and other exciting fields. Before we dive in and get our hands dirty, we need to learn the terminology to arm us with the skills needed to read, study, and be literate in this specialized subject. Before we start, a note of caution. We will be concerned primarily with functions that are differentiable. So make sure you are familiar with the following calculus concepts before you continue. You need to know the definition of a derivative, the derivative of a slope, conditions under which a derivative exists and does not exist, the rules of differentiation, the derivative as a rate of change, the relationship between the first derivative and notions of increasing and decreasing functions, the connection between the second derivative, and the concavity of a graph. Essentially, you need to understand the concepts learned in the first half of a typical Calculus 1 course. If you need to brush up on these concepts, I suggest you refresh your memory by watching the videos in the Calculus 1 section. Alright, for the most part, differential equations is all about functions and their derivatives, which themselves are functions. Say we have the function y equals e raised to the power of x squared. This function is differentiable on the interval negative infinity to infinity. In other words, all real numbers. And by applying the chain rule, we find that its derivative is equal to 2 times x times e raised to the power of x squared. Now, if we replace the e raised to the power of x squared term on the right-hand side of the equation by y, the derivative will look like this. Dy over dx is equal to 2 times x times y. If you were to hand this equation to a friend and ask them, what is the function represented by the symbol y? Well, guess what? Your friend is face to face with one of the basic problems in this course. Specifically, how do you solve such an equation for the unknown function? You already know the answer to this specific differential equation. The function we're looking for is y equals e raised to the power of x squared. The equation that we created is called a differential equation. A differential equation, dE for short, is an equation containing the derivative of one or more dependent variables with respect to one or more independent variables. In order to further talk about differential equations, we need to classify differential equations by type, order, and linearity. Let's start with classification by type. There are two types of differential equations, ordinary and partial. If a differential equation contains ordinary derivatives of one or more dependent variables, with respect to a single independent variable, it is said to be an ordinary differential equation, or ODE for short. For example, the following differential equations are ordinary differential equations. In the first differential equation, the independent variable is x, and the dependent variable is y. Notice that in the third differential equation, we have two dependent variables, specifically x and y. The independent variable in this case is t. This means that a differential equation can contain more than one dependent variable, so make sure you keep that in mind. If a differential equation contains partial derivatives of one or more dependent variables of two or more independent variables, it is said to be a partial differential equation, or PDE for short. For example, the following equations are partial differential equations. Notice that partial differential equations can have more than one independent variable, as opposed to ordinary differential equations, which only have one independent variable. Alright, let's talk about notation. Throughout the differential equation videos, ordinary differential equations will be written using either Leibniz notation or prime notation. By using prime notation, the first two ordinary differential equations can be written more compactly as follows. Prime notation is usually limited to the first three derivatives of a function. The fourth derivative of a function is written as follows. Instead of y quadruple prime, in general, the nth derivative of a function, y, is written as follows, using Leibniz notation. And this way, using prime notation. Notice that Leibniz notation has an advantage over the prime notation. It clearly displays both the dependent and independent variable. For example, in the following differential equation, you can see that the x variable represents the dependent variable, and the independent variable is t. In addition, Newton's dot notation is usually used in science and engineering, especially when denoting derivatives with respect to time. For example, the third ordinary differential equation can be rewritten using Newton's dot notation as follows, where each dot represents a derivative with respect to time. This differential equation can be rewritten as s double dot equals negative 12. Partial derivatives are often denoted using subscript notation, indicating the independent variable. For example, the following partial derivatives can be rewritten as follows. Partial differential equations are usually taught in a second course of differential equations, and for the most part, we will only focus on ordinary differential equations. Alright, now let's talk about classification by order. The order of a differential equation, either ODE or PDE, is the order of the highest derivative in the equation. For example, the following differential equation is a second order ordinary differential equation. At first glance, you might think this differential equation would be a third order ODE. But notice that the derivative is actually being raised to the power of 3. The function is being cubed. The actual function is a first order derivative that is being cubed. So be careful, make sure you identify the actual derivative and do not use algebraic exponents as a means to classify the differential equation. Using prime notation, this differential equation can be written as follows. Again, notice that the first order derivative is being cubed. The highest derivative is a y double prime term, so this differential equation is a second order ODE. Let's talk about first order ODEs. First order ODEs are occasionally written in differential form. For example, if we assume that the y denotes the dependent variable and x the independent variable in the following first order ODE, we see that we don't have a y prime term, but we know that it will be equal to dy over dx. So we can divide the ODE by the differential dx and obtain the following. And now we can explicitly see that this is a first order ODE. In symbols, we can express an nth order ordinary differential equation in one dependent variable by the following general form, where f is a real valued function of n plus 2 variables. For both practical and theoretical reasons, we will make the assumption that it is possible to solve an ordinary differential equation of this form uniquely for the highest derivative in terms of the remaining n plus 1 variables. A word of caution, there are exceptions nonetheless, and I will go over some of these exceptions in the next video where we will go over some examples. With that being said, if we assume that we can solve for the highest derivative, we can rewrite this expression in terms of the nth derivative as follows, where f is a real valued continuous function. This form is referred to as the normal form of an nth order ordinary differential equation. When n equals 1, we have a first order ODE and it has the following general form. When n equals 2, we have a second order ODE and it has the following general form. For example, the normal form of the following first order ODE is written as y prime equals x minus y over 5x. And the normal form of the following second order ODE is written as y double prime is equal to y prime minus 5y. Finally, an nth order ODE can be classified by linearity. In general, an nth order ODE is said to be linear if f is linear in y, y prime, y double prime, and so on. In other words, it has the following general form. When n equals 1, a first order linear ODE would have the following form. And when n equals 2, a second order linear ODE would have the following form. What I want you to notice is that there are two characteristic properties of linear ODEs. 1. The dependent variable y and all its derivatives are of the first degree. That is, the power of each term involving y, the dependent variable, is equal to 1. 2. The coefficients of the dependent variable and its derivatives depend at most on the independent variable x. For example, the following differential equation is a linear first order ODE. When we write the current differential form into the alternative form, by dividing by the differential dx and moving the independent variable x to the right side of the equation, we have the following form. Notice that our a sub 1 term is 5x and only contains the independent variable x. And our g of x term is x. In addition, the dependent variables and its derivatives are of the first degree. Likewise, the following differential equation is a linear second order ODE. And finally, the following differential equation, alternatively written as y triple prime plus x times y prime minus 5y equals e to the x, is a linear third order ODE. The alternative to a linear differential equation is a non-linear differential equation. A non-linear ODE is simply one that is not linear. Non-linear functions of the dependent variable or its derivatives, such as sine of y, e to the y, and the natural log of y, cannot appear in a linear equation. For example, the following differential equation is a nonlinear first-order ODE because it contains a nonlinear term. The coefficient a sub 1 depends on y. Remember, it could only contain the independent variable x to be considered a linear ODE. Likewise, the following differential equation is a nonlinear second-order ODE because it contains the nonlinear term cosine of y. Notice that we could actually make this ODE linear if the cosine function contained the independent variable x, as opposed to the dependent variable y. Finally, the following differential equation is a nonlinear fourth-order ODE because the independent variable y is raised to the power of 2. In other words, its power is not equal to 1. This is a perfect example where I want you not to confuse the derivative notation with that of an exponent when determining if an ODE is linear or nonlinear. Okay, so these are the basic ways differential equations are classified. They are classified by type, either they are ordinary or partial differential equations. They are also classified by order, first, second, third, and so on, and whether they are linear or nonlinear. Alright, in our next video we will go over some examples and practice classifying differential equations.